to teach at Momo in 1972, when I would have been 27. I remember in the spring, really stressful times, walking at Momo and the lake collapsing.
Literally, the lake sort of collapsed.
I don't believe I ever fell, but for a chalk who was used to running around, it was surprising. Later, I was able to look back on those as being the first symptoms, and noticed that they it was in the spring. When I first moved to Boston in 1982, I remember having a doctor's appointment down near Kenner Square, and hurrying to get there, I noticed my vision beginning to fog up.
It was very weird.
And that would happen to me if I was dancing such that I really built up a sweat.
It was like a fog settling in the room.
And then the summer of 1986, just before Margaret
funny shoes.
Well, yeah, I'm wearing clogs, 'cause I've got to teach a clog workshop at the end of the summer.
That must be it. Stop wearing those for a while and see if it does anything.
So I did, and it did.
There isn't very much We can give you steroids if the symptoms get bad.
Okay, said I, if that's all that you can do, you probably won't see me again. Okay, said I, so off I went.
Do what you have to do to keep doing what you want to do. Don't let it stop you doing the things that you love to do. Don't let it stop you. Don't let it stop you. Don't let it stop you doing the things that
stop you doing the things you love to do. Louis Killen's wife at the time, my mother, had MS when she was young, and so I called her up. She said, what you have to do is figure out what you have to do to keep it under control, and if it's food, fine. Ultimately, it may be things like wheelchairs. Figure out what you're not going to be able to do without in your life, and then do what you have.